Hi, I am Christy, a co-founder of Christy Fair Art Studio, and I am a painter, and I live in Ajijic, Jalisco, Mexico. And every morning as I walk my dogs, I am looking for inspiration. I'm looking for painting subjects, and in these videos I want to share with you some of my morning practice as I sketch different subjects, sometimes flowers, sometimes architectural subjects like houses and doors. Here I am back from my morning walk, and I picked up a beautiful branch of bougainvillea, and this is gonna be my first attempt to sketch flowers and add some color. In the last, I don't know, 2 years, I haven't done work on this subject. But my goal is to share with you my successes and my mistakes. Just, I'm an experienced painter. I've been painting for as long as I can remember, but I go through different subjects. So for a long time, I painted doors and buildings and streets of Mexico, and other subjects that I like to paint are pre-Hispanic idols and masks, Aztec and Mayan. So this is my interest, but occasionally I paint flowers. So my goal here is for you to see that I pretty much don't stress over the precision of my drawing. I draw straight with a Sharpie or a gel pen. I like to use tools, the Sharpie or the gel pen, I like them to be waterproof. So if I decide to put paint on top, the black is not gonna bleed into the color and pollute it. Right now I am sketching the petals, and I am looking at the structure of the petal, and I notice that all of them have a pointy end. My goal here is more to capture the overall feel of the flower than the precision of the flower. I have study art at School of Visual Arts in New York, and I've been painting, selling my art and teaching for the last 30 years. I wrote curriculum for some colleges in the States, and also taught at several across the country. In Mexico, I've been teaching for the last 12, 15 years, and right now I offer workshops from Ajijic, Jalisco, Mexico, which is an absolutely beautiful, stunning little town. And I also offer workshops online. So if you are interested in learning to sketch from photo or from life, I do one-on-one workshops as well as groups. Okay, so back to the sketch. So if you you can see now I'm adding some dimension to the leaves by adding a little more shape, more shades to them. And I moved that little leaf that is on the left of the flower on the left. I moved it in between the two branches of flowers because to me it makes more sense from a composition perspective. So I'm looking at the flowers and I'm just adding some shading to make them more three-dimensional. The next stage here is gonna be adding some color. And I'm gonna add some color with acrylics. I could have done this with watercolors, but I really like acrylics, and they do have the transparency of the watercolor if you use a lot of water. The acrylics that I'm going to be using are fluid acrylics. I'm going to use a container with water. I'm going to move my cup so I don't confuse it with the container of water. And here are the brushes that I'm going to use, which are really acrylic brushes. I have a variety of purples, red, and white. I don't think I'm going to use much white because it makes the color opaque. But nevertheless, I'm just adding a drop of it just to have it ready, just in case. And so the brushes I have, I think I have a number 2 that is round and a number 5 that is flat. I'm really gonna only use 2 of them. I'm going to start with a watercolor technique where I am adding water over the petals of the flowers. And then I'm going to change brushes. I'm going to go to the round brush. And here it's a little piece of paper towel I'm going to use. And as I pick up a little paint, I just let it bleed into the water. Letting the color bleed into the water is characteristic to watercolor technique. This is where the beauty of watercolor comes through. And I'm creating a contrast between the areas that have a more solid paint and more transparent paint, and vary the colors, the purples and the pinks. And so I'm not really stressing over perfection. I am an expressionist painter, and my goal is to capture the feeling, capture the overall experience of this bougainvillea, not necessarily the exactitude of the exact color, exact tones, shades, and so forth. I don't use white out. Some people use, kind of a masking fluid that it's conserving the white areas. I really don't like using that. I find it to be rigid in the end. So if I want to have a little bit of white space, I just preserve the white space. I just realized that I didn't prepare my greens, so no problem. I'm just gonna I just incorporate whatever happens. I just accept the fact I'm making a video. I don't have the greens. I don't want to pose. Okay, so I keep going. So I'm going to use the pen to enhance some of the lines here. And I'm not so much looking at the real flower anymore. Right now, I want to make sure that I don't lose the overall feel of it, but I'm not really looking at it as much as I did in the beginning. What I like about those flowers also is that I have a little shadow. The shadow is created by the light from the window, which is coming from my left, and artificial light that's coming from my right. So adding the shadow of the petals, I think it always gives a lot of dimension to any object, even though it's what I've done here is pretty abstract. It's not a true representation of the bougainvillea. And I'm pretty happy with the way it's coming along, taking in consideration that I have probably 2 years without sketching or painting flowers. So I think it's acceptable. And what I want to teach you, I suppose, I mean, what is most important to me to show you and to demonstrate to you is to have confidence, to enjoy the process and make decisions. And if you think that decisions are wrong, just incorporate them. It's more important to keep going, and especially if you have good instructions from a good teacher that can explain you the basics, then you can really grow as an artist and just continue painting and look for the essential. It's much more important than unless your goal is to be a realistic painter, and that's a wonderful goal, you can go for this. So this is my first day out of a series of demonstrations that I am planning to do for you. If you would like to learn more about drawing, sketching, painting, contact me, send me an email, or leave me a comment here under in the comment section. I would love you to leave a comment, and I would respond to any comments. And if anybody is interested in learning, I'll be happy to work with you. At this point, I really prefer to work with individuals than with groups. I think it's much more rewarding for you and for me, because when I teach, I like to teach you everything I know, and I like you to make as fast progress as possible, not to keep you as a student for 100 years, which I'm not planning to be here for 100 years. But the faster you learn and the faster I give you everything I know, the faster you can move on and have fun on your own. So subscribe to my channel. Please give me a like if you think you learn anything. And contact me if you want to learn one-on-one.